Okay, let's return from our break. And now we are going to set a presentation, Give Me Your Hand, Making Cooperation Work in a Simple Way, with Fabrício Pessoa from Axur and Gonzalo Romero from Neustar.
So yeah, in Lima, we talked and we started some cooperation efforts, you know. And right before coming to this event here, Gonzalo sent me an email saying, okay, what if we make a presentation, you know, to talk a bit about our collaboration and cooperation effort? And he said, okay, that's fine, but you know, there's actually not much for us to show because it's something that's very simple. And I said, okay, but that's the point, you know, to show, what if we show that we can actually do cooperation in a simple way? I said, okay, great. So the first title actually was Give Me a Hand. But then I thought about it, and I thought that it gives more an idea of helping than cooperating. And then I went to research about the definitions of cooperation and helping, so that we understand a bit better about the process. Okay, so we go for cooperation. Okay, the action of working or acting together for a common purpose or benefit. I really like this one. The second one, it's okay, but not for our situation, okay? The combination of person or purposes of production, purchase, or distribution of their joint benefit. Kind of. The third one I really like as well. It's from, it refers to ecology, okay? But it's really good. Mutually beneficial interaction among organisms living in a limited area, okay? I really like this one, okay? I'll go back to that one at the end, but for now, let's go for the first one, okay? Then we go for help. Okay, definition of help. To assist or aid someone to do something. To alleviate the burden of someone else by giving assistance. So for me, it gives me the idea that it's not really what we are doing. Okay, it gives me an idea that it's more one helping the other one. So it's the only one benefits. And I think there's a huge difference between cooperation and help. Or not, let's see. So let's go to the next one. So doing some more research, I found some very interesting guys that can help us get the idea of the difference between cooperation and help. And so we decided to get a little help from our friends, the elephants, okay?
Do you have the video?
Yeah. Okay. Just bring your microphone here because we don't know if the sound's gonna go.
Chimps and dolphins move over at the smart table, the elephant needs a seat. That's because scientists now believe they're among the world's most cognitively advanced animals. Elephants recently aced an IQ test, with two of them even figuring out shortcuts the researchers hadn't thought of. Here's how the test worked. Researchers placed a sliding table holding bowls of corn on one side of a volleyball net. A rope was tied around the table so that it would only move if two elephants working together pulled on the dangling ends of the rope. In this first video, elephants Umpang and Cod successfully pulled the rope at the same time. On the next clip, Wanali is released first and then waits for Jojo to arrive before pulling. On this video, impatient elephant Sri Siam fails to wait for his partner. By the time the second elephant gets there, the rope is out of reach and no one gets the reward. Finally, and to the surprise of the researchers, these two elephants used an alternative strategy in getting the corn, with the one at the bottom of the video holding the rope in place with her foot, while the other pulls the rope with her trunk. Scientists say the test highlights not only the intelligence of individual elephants, but also their ability to cooperate and understand the value of teamwork. The study is published in the latest Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences. Go here to read more about the findings. For Discovery News, I'm Jorge Ribas.
Okay, so I think this one...
We need to learn a lot.
Which one is this one? Is this one? No,
yeah.
It's the other one. Okay, here we are. So, the idea that it gives at the end is that, as it showed that, is that if only one works, you know, it's not good. The benefit, there's no benefit. No one benefits from the action of only one. But if they work together, they cooperate, and then everybody benefits from that. And I think that this is the main difference between help and cooperation. You can help someone because you find it's good and it's the nice thing to do, but you don't expect anything in return. When you cooperate, everybody benefits from that. That's why we think that the way to go is cooperation. Find ways of working together towards one benefit that's for everybody. So, requirements. When we talk about cooperation, we see that there are some challenges to that. So we decided to take our case, and we made some questions. So, is it absolutely required to sign MOUs, NDAs, or official agreements? These absolutely require special data exchange protocols. What are the requirements for cooperation? Okay. So the simple cooperation requirements, okay? I just want to make it clear that we are not against not an agreement or NDA or MOU, okay? The thing is that it's not always that necessary. And when in our case, when you talk about the simple way of cooperating, it's not necessary. All you need is a partner, common interests, things that we do in our day-to-day operations that may be useful for the partner, things that can be easily shared, focus on what can be done, not on what cannot be done, or obstacles, and the most important, trust. Okay, why I put that as the most important? Because this trust is a very interesting thing, because it is at the same time a purpose, a benefit, and a requirement. Why do I say that? Because it's a requirement, because you have to trust at least at a certain level so that you start the cooperation effort, right? But it's a benefit as well, because the simple way of cooperating that we are sharing simple things. We are doing things that in our day-to-day operation, so it doesn't require much effort. And if you find something that can be easily shared, that you don't need maybe an NDA or MOU, that can be a way of developing trust. Okay, so you find something that you can work, that it's not that critical. Start with that and then build the rest. So that's why I say that it's a requirement, of course, because you have to have a certain level of trust to start the thing, but it's a benefit, because if it works out, you're gonna build a trust, a stronger relationship and a more trustworthy relationship. And it's a purpose, because you can use this simple cooperation effort to develop that trust that you're still not very sure about. Okay, so I think this is the main thing of the simple cooperation, it's trust. Okay.
Okay, I would like to show you our simple cooperation case. It's based on easily collaboration IPR between Axor, the companies of Fabricio, and .co, which is is a subsidiary of Neustar in Colombia. What was the purpose of the cooperation?
Can I just interrupt?
Yeah.
We just got the first meaning that we put before. Okay, that the action of working and acting together for a common purpose or benefit, to use as a definition for this cooperation effort that we had. Sorry for interrupting.
No problem. So the main thing for one of the partners was, hey, we need more analysis of .co URLs, for example. We need to share, or we need to work more together in incident response as actions and as immediate actions, and how to follow up on that kind of actions in regard to .co URLs or malware, involved in malware, in phishing, or malicious activities as well, at the same time. Okay, the purposes. We thought about what kind of purposes we need to meet. The first one is to reduce the possibility of false positives. We need to validate our information. We need The second one is, hey, we need more exhaustive verification prior to notify the incidents to the registrants or to the registrars. To increase the fraud detection efficiency. We receive a lot of feeds, a lot of sources, but we need to validate that kind of information. And we are a single group of people. We need more efforts together to bring more exhaustive verification. And we think that our partners in this could be actually our partner. And the last one of our purposes in this kind of cooperation effort was to increase of trust between the partners. As we work on this, we are working in trust each other more efficiently. And the benefits. That's the main part. More frauds detected and faster reaction. If we work together, identified in a very fastest way, we can react more efficiently as well. We are working in this case particular for more a cleaner website on .co, for example, websites and online content. And this is a win-win-win-win experience for us as partners and for our customers and both sides, the partners as well. And the last one of the benefits is a stronger and most trustworthy relationship between us. That's when we thought on cooperation and collaboration efforts, we identify benefits, actions, and purposes for doing a single way collaboration effort. What was the hands-on? One partner, us, we have a NewSTAR registry threat mitigation service. We generate a daily email with .co alerts after the duplication and page not found review, and forward that email to trusted validators. Actually, it's one of the partners to send that kind of validators. The Associate of Axure validate that URLs, receive, parse, and research every .co alert in the email. Every .co incident, when Axure see there is a malicious activity on .co's URL, they send us a notification to our cert at NewSTAR to work on. And then we receive a daily email report of the validation Axure is giving to us, was bringing to us after the validation effort. And both parts, Axure and NewSTAR, we follow up the incident at both parts of the at the same time.
So. Okay, so then we go back to the cooperations. Why should we all cooperate, okay? So basically, because the bad guys do, and they've been quite successful. If you see when there's a new exploit and things like that, you go to the deep web, the guys are all talking about that, they exchange information and they help each other. So if they do that on their side, why shouldn't we do that in our side, okay? Because we are all on the same, I always say that, but I'm gonna repeat here, okay? Because we are all on the same boat, and if we sink together. So we would rather say, oh, keep sailing, right? Because that's the only way to go. We cannot, like the elephants, when the only one tried to pull the rope, it didn't work. For us, it's the same thing. We can try, you can have at some level of success, but you're not gonna be able to solve the problem by yourself. Actually, solve the problem is a bit too much, but to be actually successful if you work by yourself, okay? We have to work together. And most importantly, it's a now going back to the ecology definition of a cooperation. It's a mutually beneficial interaction among organisms living in a limited area. Okay, it's a benefit for everybody if we cooperate. Okay, we all have a common purpose. The common purpose of working for a safer web. For all here, I think we all have the same purpose, okay? And everybody benefits from it. Well, maybe not the bad guys, okay? But we don't care about them, right? So I think that this is the main, that we already have enough
and enough reasons for us to cooperate. So the main idea is exactly that we try and find a simple ways of cooperating, because this can be a way of building trust that can lead to other efforts that may be a bit more complicated, okay? Now, things to think about, okay? Because I know that it's not always easy, okay? But there are some things that we wanted to point out for us to reflect about this thing about simple cooperation, okay? Trust is like a relationship. It starts with a gut feeling, and no agreement can replace that. So if you don't have that gut feeling that you can trust that person, it's not going to be an NDA or MOU that's going to change that, okay? So you have to have that feeling. If you find it difficult to trust people, you're not ready or you're not the right person to start cooperation efforts, okay? And this is another thing that it happens. Sometimes, for example, one person had a bad situation of when they tried to cooperate and it wasn't successful, and this person decides not to cooperate with anybody anymore. It doesn't work that way. It's one of the other points that I made here, that like anything in life, cooperation efforts can go wrong, okay? But you have to find, that's exactly why we think that the simple cooperation is so important, because it's something that can be easily shared, so the impact's not gonna be that much if things go wrong. We think that this is a good way of starting things. It might not be the thing that's gonna solve all the problems, but it's a good point to start. I just skipped one and I'm going back now. Trust is built by human interactions and requires at some point a leap of faith. Because that's it, you know? You can never be 100% sure that things are gonna go right, okay? So you can try and look for references of the person that you're cooperating with, try and see who you're cooperating with, where you find that person. You're not gonna start cooperation efforts with the first person that you meet, okay? But it requires a leap of faith. Find something that you can do together, work on that, and use the experience to go further or not. As I said, maybe you're going to start the cooperation and you actually see that person is not the right person to cooperate. You think that it doesn't work out very well, so don't go further, okay? But if you see that it goes, maybe you can try and develop into something more complex. And one thing that I think is very important is coming from a guy that's not technical, okay, and that has been going to lots of conferences and so, is that technology is a tool, but not the key point, okay? Focus on human connections, interactions, and actions for solutions, not on technology, okay? This is important because When we go to security conferences, most people are technical, and I see that there is a lot of discussion about technical stuff that is very important, okay? But I think that there's already enough people working on the technical side. Maybe now it's the point of starting to try and start working on the human part of the things. If you see lots of security problems are not technology problems, they are people problems, they are human problems. So maybe that's the tweak. Maybe we should start looking into from different perspectives to try and find for solutions. Okay, and that's it. It's another. It's short and simple as the cooperation should be, and doesn't focus too much on the technical part. But it's just we just wanted to bring this as a case, because I know that, well, I think most of you know me, and everywhere I go, I always talk about cooperating and so. And this was an opportunity for us to try and bring something, you know, that's concrete, is an action, it's being done, and to show you that it can be done. Okay.
And to keep it simple.
Yeah, and to keep it simple. Yeah. So thank you very much. And just to finish, we want to leave you with. Where is that message, the image? Sorry, it's here. Yep. Yeah, I think it's a very interesting image that I found when I was looking for images to put. And that's it, you know? That sometimes I think and it's understandable, especially in the security field, that we don't feel comfortable sometimes, and that we have fear. You know, what if we do things wrong? But that's the only way to go ahead, is if you have trust. Otherwise, you just take the turns and you don't get get out of there. Yeah. Okay? Questions?
Thank you, Fabrício. Thank you, Gonzalo. We are open to questions.
Como para llevarle un poco la contra a mi amigo Gonzalo, yo le voy a preguntar en español. La respuesta puede ser en cualquiera de los dos idiomas, no hay problema. ¿Cómo pensás que se pueden construir estas relaciones de confianza? ¿Cómo puede ser el paso para que la gente pueda avanzar y romper las barreras que hay entre el compartir información?
¿Contestas tú o contestas tú? Dale tú y después.
Vale. Bueno, la verdad es que creo que la cosa principal es de las cosas que hablamos ahí. Una de las cosas es buscar algo que puedas compartir, ¿vale? Que no sea algo que si se no te va bien, te va a tener un montón de problemas, ¿vale? Y empezar con el sencillo. Porque es eso, la verdad es que para hacer una acción más amplia de cooperación, necesitas de la confianza, ¿vale? Pero ¿cómo vas a empezar con esta confianza? Tienes que empezar con algo. Y esta creo que es una de las ideas que ponemos de cooperation in a simple way, ¿vale? Del modo sencillo, que es busca algo que sea simple de hacerlo, busca lo complicado y empieza por ahí. Y luego, porque eso te va a ayudar a desarrollar y a crear una confianza entre tú y el partner. Ahí vas a tener una temperatura de decir, mira, vale, aquí está funcionando bien, podemos ir más adelante. Pero creo que sería una cosa importante e interesante si todos pudiéramos pensar cuál es la cosa más fácil que puedo hacer que para empezar un esfuerzo de cooperación. Porque creo a veces se ve que se queda demasiado complicado, se complica las cosas, intenta empezar algo y se complica si quiere buscar lo más perfecto, y a veces no hace falta que sea lo más perfecto, pero sí lo más sencillo y algo que sea que puedas hacer. Creo que lo más importante, y el foco en lo que puedes hacer y no lo que no puedes hacer. Claro, por ejemplo, en eventos como este, si las personas están aquí, ya puedes más o menos pensar que, mira, son personas que lo llevan en serio y que podemos a lo mejor pensar y empezar algo. Puedes ver, por ejemplo, si la organización participa de otros forums, si va a los eventos, busca referencias, habla con la gente, mira, ¿conoces este tipo? ¿Qué tal? ¿Qué tal te parece? Busca referencias y ahí empieza a hacer el esfuerzo, ¿vale? Pero mucho de la confianza se va a generar justo con la iniciativa de cooperación.
Yo voy a continuar con la parte humana, y es que, digamos, tal vez Fabrício no viene del mundo técnico. Yo soy ingeniero, digamos, primero. Pero yo he descubierto que nosotros como ingenieros muchas veces tratamos de resolver las situaciones y los hechos de una manera mucho más tecnológica, o siempre estamos como tratando de construir un mundo alrededor de lo tecnológico o de cómo eso es lo que nos va a resolver la situación, y nos alejamos de lo más importante, que es la parte humana, la parte de relacionamiento, ¿sí? Creo que si nosotros como ingenieros y como comunidad técnica y como comunidad de seguridad que estamos acá, cambiáramos un poco el chip hacia volvernos más humanos y recordar que eso, primero que todo, somos seres humanos que estamos contribuyendo y estamos buscando causas comunes, acciones comunes, beneficios comunes, propósitos comunes, ¿sí? Previo a todo eso, haríamos que lo tecnológico fuese mucho más rápido de desarrollar y más simple. Muchas veces si trabajamos al contrario, cuando llegamos a la parte humana incluso comenzamos a tener problemas. O sea, la experiencia en este caso particular te la voy a compartir muy fácilmente. Yo pertenezco hoy a una compañía de unas 2.000 personas, donde si yo hubiese querido hacer un partnership con Axur, me hubiera costado muchísimo tiempo en escalar desde la óptica legal, desde la óptica de los registry, desde muchas perspectivas de la compañía, para poder llegar a algo que en principio era muy simple, que era simplemente buscar un objetivo, un propósito y una acción sencilla que nos conviniera a ellos y a nosotros, ¿sí? pero muchas veces nos, digamos, nos frenamos o nos complicamos nosotros en tratar de buscar esos caminos que no necesariamente son los que conducen a la cooperación o a la colaboración. Y en ese recorrido es donde perdemos la sintonía, donde perdemos el acercamiento, ¿sí? Todos podemos tener muy buenas intenciones, pero cuando creemos que lo tenemos que llevar a toda nuestra faraónica organización para que se puedan dar, ahí ya estamos ya, digamos, cerrando la brecha de la confianza. ¿Sí? Cuando en realidad lo que nos convocó a armar el ideal era algo muy sencillo que podíamos compartir. Entonces, y no necesariamente tenemos que siempre pensar en que los demás decidan por un acuerdo de colaboración. Nosotros mismos, dentro de nuestra parte humana, podemos construir esa base de confianza que hace que lo que vayamos a hacer sea serio, tenga un propósito, tenga un beneficio, y al final del día es lo que vale. Eso es como lo que nosotros hemos visto como aliados en estos casos que contribuyen, ¿sí? ¿Sí? En un momento, o sea, no, tal vez no ser más explícitos. Axur tiene clientes, nosotros tenemos registrantes, ¿sí? Si nosotros encontramos situaciones que en un momento dado me puede enviar a mí para un cliente de él, ¿cierto? Yo estoy haciendo un trabajo para él que beneficia a los clientes de él, ¿sí? ¿Cuánto está costando eso para Axur en términos de fidelidad? ¿Tiene que haber un intercambio económico para hacerlo? No, porque estamos buscando, tenemos un beneficio común, ¿sí? Nosotros somos su brazo armado, su brazo de articulación, de proceso, de incidencia, para garantizar que el cliente de él esté satisfecho con el trabajo del partner. Igual pasa si en un momento dado requerimos validar información, ¿sí?, que nuestro grupo de trabajo por X o Y motivo no puede validar. El mundo de la seguridad es muy dinámico. Cuando nosotros vamos y miramos una situación en un dominio, ¿sí?, en un específico momento podemos encontrar un resultado, pero un validador como ellos, como partner, puede encontrar un resultado distinto en otro momento, ¿sí?, antes o después, ¿sí? Y ahí es donde comienza a trabajarse el modelo dinámico de confianza, ¿sí? Entonces creo que eso es lo más importante, ¿sí? Fíjense que aquí mostramos una cosa muy sencilla, no es, es un correo electrónico, no es un API, no nos tuvimos que poner de acuerdo en construir un puente o en construir una infraestructura, un sistema para, no, es algo muy sencillo que nos está beneficiando de una manera casi que inmediata en el seguimiento de las incidencias de seguridad. No sé si respondo a tu pregunta.
Obrigada. Thank you. Any more question? Okay. So, thank you very much, Gonzalo. Thank you very much, Fabricio.